Hi there, Doug Steinman with IT Creations. Today we have the Lenovo ThinkStation PX Workstation. This is Lenovo's most powerful workstation to date. And remember, we are talking 2023, so don't leave a comment 2 years from now saying, oh, Lenovo's most powerful workstation. Today, it is. Dual processors, up to 4 terabytes of memory, 4 GPUs. By the way, hit that subscribe button if you like watching our videos. It does help us continue to create more content. Too much of a commitment? Then let's move on. Just like the Lenovo ThinkStation P5, the PX also had a little help from Aston Martin in the design department. While still recognizably a Lenovo workstation, it has definitely been given an aesthetic upgrade. I went a little overboard with the Aston Martin influence on the Lenovo P5 video, which you can see here. I won't bore you with the details again, but here's a short little clip. The P5 only had a single Intel Xeon W2400 CPU. This one has dual 4th generation Intel Xeon scalable processors with up to 60 cores and 120 threads each. It also supports up to 4 terabytes of DDR5 memory and a mix of PCI 5.0 and 4.0 expansion slots. Oh, and support for 4 RTX 6000 GPUs, the Ada Lovelace generation GPUs. Storage is variable depending on how you outfit the system, but we will get to that. This chassis is on the larger side and definitely heavier than the P5 workstation. Fully configured, the PX can weigh in at almost 80 pounds. On the front of the system, there's a control panel strip running off-center to the right with a power on button, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports, and 2 USB-C Gen 3.2 ports. Those USB ports are only available on select models, like ours. That last slot is a combo headphone microphone jack. At the very bottom is an optional lock for those 3 flex bays to the right of the control panel strip. Those flex bays can be outfitted with up to 3 3.5-inch hard disk drives with hot swap on select models. Alternatively, you can install 2 dual M.2 SSD cages, again, in select models, each of which will support 2 M.2 drives for a total of 4 M.2 drives up front. Are you interested in the Lenovo ThinkStation PX workstation? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed on our site or one that you can configure at itcreations.com that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to see more information. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. itcreations.com, where you can find the best deals on the latest hardware and legacy hardware for that matter. On the back of the system, there are 2 1850-watt 80-plus platinum power supply units, which can be used for redundancy and hot swapped in the event one of them fails or the UPS they're attached to goes south. This is a good feature if the system will be rack mounted in a server room, offering an easy replacement without shutting the system down. For ultimate power, those PSUs can be used in team mode to provide 2,350 watts of juice. In team mode, both PSUs are powering the system without redundancy. That too would not be a standard power supply outlet. PSU Bay 2, which is the one on the bottom, can also be outfitted with a storage cage for a 3.5 inch drive. Ours has the dual PSU option. On the top, PCI slots 1 through 5 are controlled by CPU 2, while PCI slots 6 through 9 on the bottom are controlled by CPU 1. In between are more ports, including a line-in and line-out audio port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 port, a block of 4 USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, and 2 USB 2.0 ports. That USB-C 3.2 Gen 2x2 port delivers 2 lanes of 10 gigabit per second operations for a potential 20 gigabit per second data transfer rate. Besides those, an optional 9-pin serial port with a gigabit Ethernet RJ45 port below that. Another RJ45 port provides 10 gigabit Ethernet. Optional on this system is Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, again, only for select models. As an option, you can also get PS2 ports, which are those dedicated ports specifically for a mouse and keyboard. Those other brackets on the side hold the keys to the front bays and side panel, or as Lenovo likes to call them, the key nest. Here you can see the Lenovo ThinkStation P5 compared to the ThinkStation PX we're looking at today. While supporting a similar design language, the interior layout is where the PX really shines. It is a more expensive system and definitely looks it from the inside. That said, the P5 is more of a high-end entry-level system with that single Intel Xeon W2400 series CPU. Well, not really entry-level, but definitely more of a system that would be adopted for most users who want high-end performance. Taking the middle bracket in this lineup is the P7 ThinkStation. The P7 supports an Intel Xeon W3400 CPU, which offers a boost in performance and cores over the W2400 series. On the side panel latch, you can see the other Aston Martin influence emulating the action of the recessed door latch. Maybe not a direct translation, but inspired. I mean, fully outfitted, this system would break six figures, but not the $570,200 starting price of the Aston Martin DBS Superleggera Volante. Once we unlock and remove the side panel, the interior is very well laid out with a plastic air cowl directing fresh air pulled in from that stylish front grille over critical components and specifically isolating the CPUs and memory modules in their own thermal zone. The PCI slots for CPUs 1 and CPU 2, where the GPUs are mounted, also have distinct thermal zones. That control panel on the front also separates the workstation into two thermal zones with the front drive bays and PSUs on one side of the motherboard, CPUs, memory, and PCI slots on the other. A bank of four fans at the front pulls in fresh air from the front of the chassis, while two fans in the middle funnel in air through the plastic air shroud with a single fan on top and the bottom for the PCI lanes where GPUs or additional SSDs would be installed. Two more fans at the back middle pull the CPU-centered air out the back of the chassis. The four front fans are easy to remove individually or can be removed altogether with latches on the top and bottom of the case. Most everything in the case can be removed without using any tools. It's quite easy to strip this system down to the motherboard in a matter of minutes. This system can be outfitted with one or two fourth generation Intel Xeon scalable CPUs, including Platinum 8490H CPUs with up to 60 physical cores and 120 virtual threads. In a dual processor configuration, that would be up to 120 cores and 240 virtual threads. Gold and silver are also supported, offering 8 to 32 processor cores each. Those 60-core Platinum CPUs have a base clock of 2.9 GHz and a maximum frequency of up to 3.5 GHz, not to mention 80 PCI 5.0 lanes to work with, for up to 160 PCI 5.0 lanes in a dual processor configuration. Not only PCI 5.0, but CXL 1.1 support of next-generation workloads. Apparently, CXL is the next big deal and uses the same PCIe physical layer with reduced compute latency. All good. I mean, not that it really matters at this point. I don't know of any CXL devices currently supported on the system. Each of the processors is in charge of 8 DDR5 memory module slots for 16 total slots. With 8 memory channel architecture, each memory module resides in its very own memory channel for optimal performance. Optimal performance includes memory speeds of up to 4800 MHz, but only 4800 MHz at the top Platinum end of the Intel Xeon scalable processor scale. Other processors in the lineup, like the gold and silver options, only support memory speeds of 4400 MHz and 4000 MHz respectively. Still much faster than the previous generation CPUs, which topped out at 3200 MHz. In fact, a 1.6 times increase in performance with DDR5 compared to DDR4. With all 16 memory module slots outfitted with 256GB DDR5 3DS RDIMM ECC memory modules, the system can support up to 4 TB of memory. Yes, 4 TB. That said, those 256GB DDR5 memory modules are quite expensive. Not to mention, for best performance, a single memory module in all 8 slots per CPU is recommended to fully utilize the bandwidth offered by those 8 memory channels. Our system has a single 4th generation Intel Xeon scalable gold 5416S processor with 16 physical cores and 32 virtual threads. 30 megabytes cache plus a base frequency of 2 GHz and a max turbo frequency of 4 GHz. It supports memory speeds of up to 4400 megatransfers per second with either 1 DIMM per channel or 2. We've only got 8 memory module slots per CPU and 8 memory channels per CPU, so 2 DIMMs per channel is not really an option. With the S suffix, this processor is storage optimized with full accelerators optimized. There are definitely a few more suffixes, to choose from, which offer benefits for certain workloads. That just might be the subject for another video though. We have all memory module slots connected to that one processor outfitted with 16GB memory modules for up to 128GB of memory total. There are several management tools that come with the Windows operating system, but Lenovo has a few others to help you out. For the hardware configuration, you can type Device Manager in the Windows search box. If you need some troubleshooting or diagnostics, you can click the error message of the ThinkStation Diagnostics icon and check the logs for possible solutions. Optional is a diagnostic LED panel. If the panel displays a QR code, you can scan that to open a website with the codes for that particular error. The Lenovo Vantage app comes preloaded on the system and can also help diagnose problems that might arise. By typing Vantage in the Windows search box, you can run the program and scan the hardware for errors. This system is also ISV certified for a number of applications. Lenovo says this system can be outfitted with up to 9 drives, depending on configuration. You can install two M.2 dual drive carriers in front, which will take up two of the storage bays and add four M.2 drives. That top flex bay slot can still support a single 3.5-inch drive. Then there are three M.2 slots on the system board, and you can add another 3.5-inch drive in the top PSU slot on the back of the system for a total of seven M.2 drives and two 3.5-inch drives. Optionally, you could go with four 3.5-inch drives with three up front and one in the aforementioned rear PSU slot, plus the three onboard M.2 slots for seven drives total. For hot swap and RAID options, a virtual RAID on CPU or VROC key is required. The system supports SATA drives using the onboard Intel RSTE SATA RAID controllers and an integrated PCIe NVMe controller for NVMe SSDs, but no RAID functionality. Optionally, you have a VROC key as described above for PCIe NVMe, which does offer RAID options of 0, 1, 5, or 10. Storage capacity is always changing based on new technologies and drives with higher capacities. While the system in general will support up to 9 drives, the PCIe slots can also be outfitted with more storage in the form of dual or quad M.2 carriers. If that 1 gigabit Ethernet or 10 gigabit Ethernet included with the system are not up to the task for your network, there are options here too for PCIe-based NIC controllers. You can also install a Thunderbolt card, either a Gen 3 or Gen 4, offering super fast data transfer speeds of up to 40 gigabits per second. How about a Bluetooth card or Intel Wi-Fi AX2010 WLAN module for wireless connectivity? And then you have the option for installing GPUs, two on the bottom and two on the top, assuming both CPUs are installed. Remember, the top PCIe slots are controlled by a CPU 2 and the bottom slots by CPU 1. Looking at the bottom PCIe lanes, slot 6 and slot 8 feature a PCIe 5.0 slot for GPU support, while the other two slots, 7 and 9, are PCIe 4.0. All of those have a PCIe by 16 slot length. On top, the PCIe slot closest to the CPU socket, PCIe slot 5, has a by 8 length with a PCIe 4.0 connector width. The other slots all have a by 16 slot length, but only slots 3 and 4 are PCIe 5.0. The others are PCIe 4.0. The VROC key slot is at the very bottom of the motherboard beneath that last PCIe slot. With only a single processor installed on this system, we have a single NVIDIA RTX A4500 card installed. Depending on which card you install, an NVIDIA NVLink bridge can be installed with two of the same GPUs together, enabling the two cards to function as one and combining the onboard GPU memory. Surprisingly, the RTX 6000 Ada generation is one of those cards that does not support NVLink, unfortunately. Theoretically, with two RTX 6000s linked together, that would be up to 96 gigabytes of memory between the two. Monitor support is based on the number of ports available on the GPUs. Given that, you can support up to 16 monitors if each GPU has four DisplayPort connectors. The NVIDIA RTX A4500 is a double-wide Ampere architecture-based GPU with a TDP of 200 watts and requires an 8-pin power connector. It supports real-time ray tracing, simulation, and AI with second-generation ray tracing cores and third-gen tensor cores. This card will support up to four monitors with four DisplayPort 1.4A connectors. It features 20 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory and a memory bandwidth of 650 gigabytes per second. This card is designed for demanding workloads such as physics simulation, generative AI, and rendering tasks, and does support NVLink technology. Although Aston Martin only had a little input on the design, it did improve the appearance quite a bit. If you need or want something that looks great and delivers performance, you can't go wrong with the Lenovo ThinkStation PX Workstation. It's very well designed both inside and out. It would be cool if it was available in different colors. I mean, I could see a nice royal blue, maybe even silver, but red is kind of Lenovo's branding. That said, who really cares how it looks? The performance on this system is off the hook with dual fourth generation Intel CPUs, up to 4 terabytes of DDR5 memory, upwards of 9 storage devices, not counting PCIe storage, and up to 4 double-wide 300-watt GPUs. Impressive to say the least. I do want one, but realistically, I wouldn't be using a fraction of its potential. If you made it this far, hit that subscribe button. In addition to other new servers and workstations, I do feel confident we will be getting the Lenovo ThinkStation P7 for review at some point, completing the full trifecta of Lenovo high-end ThinkStation workstations. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.